نحمده ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فهو المهتد، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. وبعد، الله سبحانه وتعالى عند قرآن ساز بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. O you who have attained faith, those who proclaim faith, the believers, be mindful, be conscious, be aware, live a life of awareness, awareness of the divine, divine values, divine commands, what's beautiful and what's ugly according to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Be conscious about everything you do. اتقوا الله, fear Allah, fear the majesty of Allah, حق تقاته, in a way that is proportional and befitting to His majesty and glory. And die not except in the state of loving surrender to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The way we live, the way we die, is about surrender, submission, acceptance of Allah's decrees and Allah's commandments. And we bring back a heart of a believer, a heart of a Muslim. وبعد, a story narrated from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Everything Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam did was beautiful. Everything Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam said is a lesson for me and for you. A role model to those who seek Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Those who seek an angelic way of living, a pure heart, a guide for those people is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. One that embodied the divine attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the best human possible way. The best heart that existed, the best words, the best dua, the best Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And today I want to share with you a story that happened in the time of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam that depicts a concept that I think is really important for us nowadays. And the story happened in Medina, narrated Abu Sa'id al-Khudri, Sunan ibn Majah, Sahih Hadith. جاء رجل جاء عربي إلى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يتقاضاه دينا فاشتد عليه حتى قال والله إني لأحرج عليك إلا قضيتني. This man, this Bedouin, came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asking for a debt. He gave the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam some dates, loaned him, and now he wants it back. But it said he came to him and he was really harsh, really yani, on the verge of being rude to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the way he asked for it, till it reached a point that he told the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, by Allah, I'm not going to make it easy for you. I'm going to make it hard for you. I'm not going to give you a way out. You have to pay me right now. You have to give it to me right now. So the companions with Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they were very upset. How can you speak to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam this way? So he said, they said, وَيْحَكْ أَتَدْرِي مَنْ تُكَلِّمْ Who want to you? Do you know who you're speaking to? This is not just your friend. This is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ إِنَّمَا أَنَا رَحْمَةٌ مُهْدَى As he said, a gift of rahmah, a gift of compassion from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How can you speak to him this way? And the man responded, إِنَّمَا أَطْلُبْ حَقِّي I'm only asking for my right. I'm only asking, you know, for, I'm not asking anything unjust. I want my right back. I'm not doing anything wrong. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, teaching us and teaching them, responds by saying the following, أَلَا مَعَ صَاحِبِ الْحَقِّ كُنْتُمْ Speaking to the companions, telling them, shouldn't you have taken the side of the one who has the right? The man might have been rude. They might have been a little bit aggressive. But what he's saying is right. Shouldn't you have taken his side? And then he, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, sent to another companion, asking her, do you have extra dates that you can loan me? And she responded, Khawla bint Qais. And she responded, بأبي أنت وأمي يا رسول الله. You know, anybody would love, imagine if Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam asks you for something. What an honor, what a pleasure. She, unlike this man, she said, by Allah, you know, I would give my father and my mother for you, O Prophet of Allah. Take it, of course I have, it's a delight to give you. and he sallallahu alayhi wasallam took the dates. And then the narration says, فَأَطْعَمَ الْأَعْرَابِ وَأَوْفَلَ. Not only he gave back to that Bedouin, but he invited him for dinner and fed him, treated him well. And then he asked the A'rabi, this man, أَوَفَيْتُ لَكَ. Now, am I good to you? Did I fulfill to you? Am I a good person? Did I do good to you? And the A'rabi said, وَفَيْتْ أَوْفَ اللَّهِ. Now you're good. May Allah be good to you. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam teaches everybody now, the companions that witnessed this incident. He says the following. Please make space and go forward. He says the following. أُولَٰئِكَ خِيَارُ النَّاسِ أَلَا إِنَّهُ لَا قُدِّسَتْ أُمَّةِ لَا يَأْخُذُ الضَّعِيفُ فِيهَا حَقَّهُ غَيْرَ مُتَعْتِعَ. Says, those are the best type of people. Indeed, a nation will never be pure, will never be purified by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala if the weak among them does not take his right undiminished. What is he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying? What is the lesson? What am I sharing with you? أولئك خيار الناس. Those type of people are the best type of people. What type of people are we speaking about? The type of people that are able to see the truth, the grain of the truth, even if it is cloaked in a garment of harshness. Because sometimes when I'm strong and I'm in a position of power, this is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. If he says something, it will go. Right? This man is no one. He's a Bedouin. He's a weak. And he's harsh. And sometimes when somebody's harsh and I'm in the position of power, his harshness causes me to do what? Out of anger and vengeance and what have you, and power, and you can't touch me and my self-esteem, I will show you, you will pay for it. But what he was saying is actually right. Khiyarunnas are the people that are able to see the truth, even if the person saying it, even the way he's saying it, is not right. The people that will not be dissuaded by the method that the words are delivered, than doing the right thing. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is teaching us this. He's teaching us a very important concept that's very relevant to us. The ability to take advice and criticism. Advice giving. When we speak about advice, the necessity of advising one another. Al-mu'min mir'atu akhi. I'm your mirror. Right? But there is two sides to it. Giving, dispensing advice, and accepting advice. Nowadays, we live in a time where don't judge me. You don't understand. Mind your own self. Look who you are. How open am I to taking advice? To seeing the truth? Even if it's delivered in a way that's not good. And on the contrary, when I'm giving advice, how do I give it? The etiquettes of giving advice and receiving advice. Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, and all of us know this hadith, and some people love this hadith, and they would say, the Prophet, ya akhi, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, الدين النصيحة. And they would translate it, الدين, religion. Religion is advice giving. نصيحة, advice. Yes, he sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that, but the translation isn't accurate. Why? Continue the hadith. So they asked, O Prophet of Allah, لمن? قلنا لمن يا رسول الله. يا رسول الله. We asked, O Prophet of Allah, to who? الدين النصيحة, نصيحة. Translated here, advice. To who, O Prophet of Allah? And he says, لله ولكتابه ولرسوله ولأئمة المسلمين وعمتهم. To Allah, to His Messenger, to His Book, to the leaders of the Muslims and to the Muslim masses, if you will. Wait a minute, are you going to give advice to Allah? الدين النصيحة, religion is advice. To who? To Allah. How does that work? I don't think nobody is going to give advice to Allah or His Messenger. No. The word advice is much deeper in the Arabic language. That's why this translation is not accurate. Nasiha from nasaha shay is purity, sincerity. So you know what this narration is saying? Religion is about the following. To have a pure heart, sincere heart, loving heart. That when I look to you out of purity, out of sincerity, out of love, that's why I speak, that's how I act. So when I'm giving advice, I'm giving it out of what? A heart of what? I love you, I'm pure, I'm sincere. It's not because I'm angry, not because I'm upset, not because you are, not because I seek vengeance. الدين النصيحة, having this clean, pure heart that when I speak to you, I speak from that heart. And why am I speaking to you? لله. I'm speaking to you so that The reason is I'm getting closer to Allah, للتقرب لله. The purpose, I'm giving you advice, brother, whether you accept it or not, I'm doing it for the sake of Allah. ولكتابي, congruent to the Quran. My advice is based on the Quran. ولرسولي, and with the method of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. The way I'm going to talk, the rifq, lean, it's going to reflect the prophetic way. That's how I speak. So advice is about what? Purity. It is not about the words that leave our lips. It's about the heart from which those words came. What do I mean? I can be standing here giving a khutbah. I can be telling you about Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, quoting some ayahs from the Quran. Those are beautiful. Those are wonderful. But if my heart is not clean, if I'm making it from a position where my heart is disfigured, stained, the words come ugly, and the light within those good words is extinguished, and people can't receive them. And sometimes say, Yahi, people don't accept my advice. Yes, because sometimes the problem is in the transmitter, not the receiver. How are you transmitting? And we transmit not with just the words, because I can tell you, say this, the way you say it, the emotions behind it, brothers and sisters. There is a big difference between the same words. The emotions, the face shows, are you saying this because you love me, you care about me? Or you're saying it because you're angry, you're putting me down. Makes a whole lot of difference. Nasiha is about, before speaking, work on this heart. Why am I speaking? Do I speak because I love you? Because this is how Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam did it quickly. How did he give advice? One thing that we can learn, that we can apply today. Before giving advice, please do this. Prophetic. And I'll give you 3-4 examples. All the same way, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. He goes, he wants to give an advice to Umar ibn al-Khattab. What does he say? Ya Umar, innaka la rajulun qawi. Fala tuzahimanna 'inda al-hajar. Ya Umar, you are a strong man. Masha'Allah. So please, when you're making tawaf around the Kaaba, be mindful, do not shove people around the black stone, you know. How did he start the advice? He praised a quality in him. Before telling him, do not shove people, which is what I want to tell you, and that's correct, and that's okay. But look how he did it. Ya Umar, I'm only telling you this because mashallah, Allah made you have such kind of brother. Alhamdulillah, mashallah. You praise first. He says, ni'ma ar-rajul Abdullah ibn Umar. لو كان يقوم الليل. What a blessed and a good man is Abdullah ibn Umar is. A wonderful man he is. Only if he can pray some nightly prayers, some qiyam. What is the advice here? Ya Abdullah ibn Umar, pray qiyam. How did he say it? نعم الرجل عبد الله بن عمر. Abdullah ibn Umar, when he heard this, he said, from that day onward, I didn't stop praying the night. That's it. When he, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, wants to give an advice, the one that really touches my heart, and I love it because of the way he delivered it. And it's very beloved to many of us, when he came to Mu'adh ibn Jabal. And the advice he gave, the way he gave it, you know, the way he delivered that gift was so beautiful. The wrapping, if you will, was such a beautiful wrapping that people loved it. Sometimes the wrapping of the gift is more beautiful than the gift itself, right? So he comes to Mu'adh ibn Jabal and he says in this wonderful narration, Ya Mu'adh, wallahi inni la uhibbuk. Ya Mu'adh, by Allah, I love you. If you heard this from Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, how much would you give for that? That Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, by Allah, you are beloved to my heart. Ya Mu'adh, wallahi inni la uhibbuk. From that point, out of that sincere love, because of your station, I'm going to give you something. I want to tell you something. لا تدعن بعد كل صلاة إلا أن تقول اللهم أعني على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك. So please, after every salah, do not ever stop saying, do it after every salah. Oh Allah, aid me, help you, help me to remember you, to worship you, to be grateful for you in the most beautiful of manners. What's the advice here? After every salah, what should we say? Allahumma a'inni ala dhikrik wa shukrik wa husn ibadatik. How did he give it to us? Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You understand that I can be sitting here, and this will determine the quality of this khutbah, by the way. And I can tell you, brothers, please, after every salah, it's the sunnah. It's very simple. It's so beautiful. When you look to the words, the meaning. Ya Allah, help me. Help me. Help me in what? Help me to obey you. I want to be beautiful in the way I obey you. I want to remember you all the time. I can do it. Help me. Ask for that. Brothers, ask for that. Versus, if I'm a sincere person and I come here and I tell you, Ya akhi, wallahi, the people sitting in this masjid, the people of Irvine, wallahi, I'm honored to be among one of you. You're the people that are carrying La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. In your heart is La ilaha illallah. If placed on one side and the heavens and the earth on the other side, it will win. You're the people that are following Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in this ummah, no matter who you are. You say La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, I'm honored to be one of you. Wallahi, I'm honored to be here. I love all of you. I really care about all of you. I love this ummah. I love this community. I love every single one of you. I see the nur of nubuwa. La ilaha illallah. Please, brothers and sisters, you're the one that are following Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Please do this. Please, after every salah, say Allahumma a'inni ala dhikrik wa shukrik wa husna ibadatik. If you go out of this door and you said, you know what? Yeah, I learned something today. I want to do it. It reflects what? The heart that delivered those words was perhaps polished. And if you go and say, what was he saying? Ya akhi, he put me down. He made me feel bad. Maybe it's my, because the words are the same. Before speaking to people, brothers and sisters, before uttering, and sometimes what you're saying is right. It is right. But the garment, كل كلام يبرز عليه كسوة القلب الذي منه برز. Words appear cloaked, clothed by the garment of the heart from which it appears. So if I want to give you advice, and I'm right, Yahi, you're smoking, stop smoking. I'll stop first and say, can I praise something in him first? What is the sunnah that we're learning? Before giving advice, look for something to praise. I can't see anything to praise. Please don't speak. Please don't speak. Find something to praise for, you know what it means? You don't know the person enough. Al-hukmu ala shay' far'an 'an tasawwuri. Judging something is based on how you conceive of it. Maybe you don't understand the person. All what I see of you is you are doing something haram, full stop. That's it. Before giving the advice, see something positive. He's coming to the masjid. He's giving charity. He's saying La ilaha illallah. He's kind with his kids. He is generous. Admire that first in your heart. Praise that first in your heart. Make it known to him. You're a good person, mashallah. Because of this and this and this. And it has to be sincere, not just a technique. This is the prophetic technique. No. Heart has to be in it. Then say what you want to say. Brother, you are smoking. Wallahi, I don't want you to get lung cancer. It's terrible. It smells bad. It does not please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This mouth says La ilaha illallah. It's beneath you. You're much better than this. How can I help you? What's going on? How can you stop? Please, I know it's difficult. What's going on? I'm giving you advice, please. It's not good for you because I care about you. You see a sister, oftentimes we pick on them, unfortunately, dressed in a very revealing way, inappropriate. How do I give her advice? Is it because I care about her or I'm upset at her? Wallahi, sister, you are the follower of Maryam alayhi salam. You are very beautiful in your haya. You have La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. You're a role model. It's not befitting. You don't need to do this. You're so beautiful, you don't have to do all this. Because I care. You're much higher in my eyes than this. What's going on? Maybe you have some challenges. How can I be of help? That's why I'm speaking. This advice giving. Ad-deen al-nasiha. Finally, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam giving advice to a young man, Abdullah ibn Abbas. Look at this, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How would you advise your kid? Son, I care about you, memorize Quran. Good, right? At least you said, I care about you first, right? My wife, I really feel it. I want things to be better between me and you. And then I speak. Versus, your food is terrible. Great. What a great advice, right? You need to take cooking classes. Can you say something else in the beginning? MashaAllah, the house is clean and you try and you take care of the kids. But you know, when it comes to cooking, can you do something like that? I see brothers smiling, right? Because we go immediately to the point and like you feel unappreciated. So he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, speaking to a kid, Abdullah ibn Abbas, how does he wants to give him an advice? Notice how he gives. He did something really wonderful. It wasn't words this time. The praise wasn't words. It was a hug. He came and he hugged Abdullah ibn Abbas strongly, in a way that showed love. He showed it not with his word. I can do that. I can hug my wife in a way that she feels this man loves me. Then I say, So he hugs him in that way. And he says, Allahumma faqihu fi ddeen. He didn't even speak to him. He made a dua. Ya Allah, make him a faqih in the matters of this deen. Abdullah ibn Abbas got it. He got what's being said to him. He became turjuman al-Quran, the one that, if you want anybody to gives you tafsir of Quran, he is Abdullah ibn Abbas. It's the dua. You made dua for him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He made it with a hug, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Express love. That's why I'm speaking to you. Ad-deenun nasiha. Deen is about my heart being that clean. That clean, that loving to you, that compassionate to you. That when I give you advice, it's because I love you. I want you to be even better than me. And if I am like that, my words will come soft, lenient, and effective. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على أفضل المرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه الطيبين الطاهرين وبعد receiving advice because also the opposite exists. خيار الناس are the people, the best people. When they give advice, they give it this way. But when they take advice, they can take advice even if it is delivered in not such a good way. Sometimes, brothers and sisters, we lose so much goodness because of what we call psychological reactance. The way we react, you tell me to do X, I'm going to do Y. Just to prove a point. You know, like kids, son, I'm going to bake some cookies for you. You can go play outside and don't watch TV. What happens? What did you say? You can play outside, you can eat cookies, but don't watch TV. I'm watching TV. Why? They call it psychological reactance because I feel that you can't take away my autonomy. This is childish. It's called psychological reactance. How am I that way? When somebody gives me advice, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud said, كَفَى بِالْمَرْءِ إِثْمًا إِذَا قِيلَ لَهُ اتَّقِ اللَّهِ قَالَ عَلَيْكَ نَفْسَكْ مِثْلُكَ يَنْصَحْنِي. It suffices of a sin for someone that whenever you tell him, اتَّقِ اللَّهِ, somebody comes and tells me and you, اتَّقِ اللَّهِ يَا حَسَنُ. What khutbah is this? اتَّقِ اللَّهِ. How do I react? إِذَا قِيلَ لَهُ اتَّقِ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكَ نَفْسَكْ. No, fix yourself first. Don't you see what you're doing? Who are you? You smoke, you do this. Look, you give me an advice. عليك نفسك مثلك ينصحني. Do I take advice from anybody? Or when I'm given advice, it's like I get aggressive. You don't understand. It happens. The Prophet ﷺ, one time, he saw a woman crying, lost someone on the grave, crying with tears, hurt. And he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, out of compassion and rahmah, he approaches her. Ya amatullah, isbiri wahtasibi. Oh, woman of God, be patient. Seek reward with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Illahtisab, yani jaza'uhu al-jannah. If you do that, Allah gives you jannah just for that. He's giving her advice. You can get jannah right now. If you say, hasbi Allah wa ni'mal wakil, see, he wants something good. But what did she didn't recognize him. So what did she say? Something that perhaps many of us would say. إِلَيْكَ عَنِّي. Go away from me. You don't understand. You don't know. You don't feel it. Who are... He doesn't understand. You know how many people sallallahu alayhi wa sallam lost in his life? He does not understand. And then he left sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And they came to her. He said, woe unto you. This is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Really? She goes, oh Prophet of Allah, I'm sorry I didn't recognize you. I'm going to be patient now. Says, nah, no. إِنَّمَا الصَّبْرُ عِنْدَ الصَّدْمَةِ الْأُولَى. Too late. Patience, that was only in the first encounter. It's too late. You lost. What do I lose? Am I that type of a person? That when people try to be sincere to me and show me something that because I don't like my negativity, I attack them. I don't accept it. I don't like that mirror. I would rather prefer a deformed mirror to show me a deformed, image that's not me so I can feel good. I'm not going to be like that. I don't want that. As Umar said, رحم الله امرئا أهدى إلي عيوبي. May Allah bless someone who gifts me with my flaws. And I finish with Imam al-Ghazali, حجة الإسلام. It's very interesting. A story that some of you know. In his time, there is no photocopiers. If you want ilm, you have to go to the library, write it down. And that's what he did. He traveled, he spent months writing down books, copying books. Hours and hours. And on the way back, the caravan was raided. Bandits, thieves. And he was, please take everything, but do not touch my books. You can take my money. See, that's what he values. See, Imam al-Ghazali, this is like ilm, this is knowledge. And he tells the thief, this is not good for you. What are you going to do with this? Take everything, but please leave this alone. This is my ilm, this is my knowledge. Don't take it away. And then that thief looks at Imam al-Ghazali and mocks him. A thief mocking Imam al-Ghazali tells him, ilm? What kind of knowledge is that someone like me can take from you and you call yourself a scholar? What kind of scholar is this if I can rob you of your ilm and you become ignorant? Called the scholarship, and he left. What did Imam al-Ghazali do? A rude person, haram, yeah, of course. Wait a minute, what he said is right or wrong? Imam al-Ghazali said, I realized that what he said is correct, and it was Allah that made him speak the truth so I can learn. And Imam al-Ghazali said, he is right. What kind of ilm is that someone like him can steal? What kind of scholar am I? If I don't know anything, I have to read. From that day on, Imam al-Ghazali learned the lesson from that thief. Every book he had, he memorized. He memorized all his book. Go ahead, steal it. You know all the books in my library? They're in my head. I got the lesson, Ya Allah, on the hands of a thief. Doesn't matter, it's the truth. Am I that type of a person that's very easy to give advice to? Even if you're harsh, even I'll pass it and I look for the grain of truth in what you're saying and start with that. Am I the kind of a person that when I give you an advice, it's because I really care and love you and I'm very sincere? And if I'm not, I'll stop and say, first, let me know. It means I don't know you, because you have to have something good. I'm not going to give you advice except first, I have to find something that I praise about you. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those khiyar al-nas, those people with pure heart, that are able out of love and compassion to say words that will affect people. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us a heart that reflects the beauty of La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not to make the light of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam be eclipsed with the stains in our own hearts. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه اللهم حبب إلينا الإيمان وزينه في قلوبنا وكره إلينا الكفر والفسوق والعصيان واجعلنا من الراشدين اللهم ارزقنا سلام الإسلام وأمن الإيمان وحسن الإحسان وصلى الله على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه